rising up aside unto the going down of the same, in the name of our Lord. Indeed is worthy to be praised. Indeed his name is worthy to be glorified. Indeed his name is worthy to be exalted and lifted in this place. We honor all of you who are in the house of the Lord on this morning, all of you, my brothers and sisters in Christ, to leadership, as well as all of the disciples of the living Lord here at the Great Harvest Church. Indeed, it is a privilege to come to church on this morning.
Yeah.
Not just come to church on this morning, but to be able to magnify the name of the Lord.
Yeah.
His name certainly is hallowed in this place.
Yes.
Grab the Bible, go with me to the Gospel according to Mark. The Gospel according to Mark, chapter 16. When you get there, meet me at verse 1. The Gospel according to Mark, chapter 16, beginning at verse 1.
Jesus was late.
You know the story that they take these spices so that they could go, and when they arrive to Jesus, once again, anoint his body. Yeah. Yeah. Now, Evangelist Harris, I was a little puzzled because I see in chapter 15 that Joseph of Arimathea, and according to other gospel writers, Nicodemus had already anointed and oiled down the body of Jesus.
Well,
yet Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, decide that they would also go and anoint the body of Jesus. Deacon Derek Johnson, I observed this text, and then the Lord revealed unto me that you can never base your worship on what somebody else has done for the Lord. Let me rewind and suggest that again. That just because somebody else has done something as a sign of worship and homage unto the Jesus that we so love doesn't mean that you cannot do what you're supposed to do.
Amen.
Because you think somebody else has already done it.
All right.
Oh, let me suggest, my brothers and my sisters, that worship and paying homage, giving homage unto our great Redeemer, is not based upon anybody else, but it's personal.
Yeah.
And I submit unto you this morning that you ought to learn to give God personal worship.
Yeah.
Don't you think because I dance across this pulpit, that's enough for you? But can I submit unto you that you got to learn how to do your own dance?
Yeah.
You got to learn how to clap your own hands. You got to learn how to lift your own voice. You got to learn how to wave your own hands. And I tell you that mama's praise can't get it for you. That daddy's praise can't get it for you. That your brother's praise can't get it trying to make their way. give up some worship for myself. I got to anoint this body for myself. I got to go and I got to buy some spices, and I got to go lay these spices and rub these spices on Jesus. And they began to talk. They said, well, there's a stone in the way that blocking us from giving to Jesus. And even though they knew there was a stone that was blocking them from giving to Jesus, they never worried about the stone.
Right?